Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to you guys all. I'd like to welcome you guys all to another Lions Leadership Program. Just to formally introduce myself, ako po si Herbert R. Buckhold, founder and president ng Lions Leaders and Organized Networking. The only thing standing between you and your goals is the story you keep telling yourself as to why you can't achieve it. Now, a lot of people complains about lack of time. It is not the lack of time. And 99% of the cases is the lack of direction kung bakit nila hindi nakukuha ang pangarap nila. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, lack of direction, not lack of time, is the problem. We all have 24 hours a day. Now, we'll go over through goal setting. Goal setting is the mind in your business. It's like your body. Kung walang utak ang body mo, mabubuhay ba ang katawan mo? Hindi. Same goes for your business. Goal setting is the mind of your business. This training video will go over the arts of goal setting. Now, if you look at this building was a goal that became a success through careful planning. Hindi bara-bara yan. So, totoo lang. Look at the way how it's architect. So, tingin mo gagawin ng mga construction worker, bigla na lang sinipag, gumising, tapos pumunta sa location na yan. Magtayo tayo dito ng building. Tapos sabi ng isa, paano natin gagawin? Basta, magtayo lang tayo. So, totoo lang. Nakaplano yan. Ginol nila yan. Every day we have goals. You just don't know it. Sometimes you're just used to it kasi naging instinct na. We have goals to eat. We have goils to go to work. Clean the house. Get an oil change for your car. Shopping with friends sa mga babae. Bibili ng mga latest magandang na bag. People has goals in buying shoes. Buying the latest gadget, the latest tablet, or the latest phone. Look at this phone. Napakaganda niya, no? I wanna get that phone someday. Some people's goal is to buy a cool gun, to buy a nice hot car, and also to buy their dream home. We are all driven by goals. That's how we are moved every day to wake up and go to one place to another, to go from point A to point B. Try going outside of the house. Wala kang plano, wala as in, wala kang kaplano-plano. Just go outside of the house, maglakad ka, at pumunta ka kahit saan. Sa tingin mo, anong mangyayari? Wala, because it's not in our instinct to do something that's not planned. That's how our body works. Before we move, pinaplano yan ng utak, ginugol yan ng utak natin. Kaya we are all goal-oriented people. You just don't know it because some of those goals are instincts already. Now in the business world, especially in multi-level marketing, goal setting is very important. Why people fail in multi-level marketing? Number one is they fail to plan. Number two is they plan to fail. Hindi tama ang plano nila. Number three, they give up on their plan. Hindi sila nagko-commit sa kung anong plano ginawa nila. Tama naman ang plano nila, pero nag-give up naman sila. Now, here are my 10 tips in goal setting. Number one, knowing what you want is the first step toward getting it. So, write down your dreams and your goals. Pero when you write them down, you have to have SMART goals. Ano yung mga SMART goals na yan? S is for specific. Dapat, you have to know what you want. M is for measurable. Know how much is your goal. A is for attainable. Make sure it's realistic. Huwag ka naman magkaroon sana ng pangarap at mag-goal pumunta sa Jupiter o sa Pluto. Kasi hindi mangyayari yun. Or sabihin natin maging space cowboy ka. Hindi mangyayari yun. Please, go back into reality. R is relevant. Meaning, importante ba sa'yo? Huwag ka mangarap at huwag ka mag-goal pag hindi naman importante sa'yo. Meron nga ako narinig eh, sinabi, gusto mo magkaroon ng airplane. Ano man ang gagawin niya sa airplane, ipaparada niya sa EDSA. Siyempre, hindi naman relevant yun. Letter T is time bound. Set a deadline. Set an achievable time, pero hindi masyadong matagal. Baka mamaya mag-set ka na naman ng deadline, pero in 30 years from now, magiging millionaire ka. Of course, masyadong na matagal yun. Make a dream board that consists of your short-term goals and your long-term goals. This is just a constant reminder na makikita mo lagi. Ito yung dream board ko. I-share ko lang sa inyo. Nakapost to sa cellphone wallpaper ko, sa wallpaper din ng laptop ko. Gumawa din ako ng tarpaulin ng dream board ko. Every time I look at it, it motivates me and it reminds me of why I am working in my multi-level marketing business every day. Now, my short-term goals is basically, yung unang kotse ko, gusto mo ko na ng Elantra. I wanna get married soon. It's a place na I wanna get married is in a beach resort like Boracay. And my first home is gonna be the condominium at the Pearl Place. As for my long-term goals, gusto ko magkaroon ng bahay sa Las Vegas para pag umuuwi ako doon, meron ako mauuwian. At gusto ko din magkaroon ng bahay sa Quarantine Hills. I want to own a very big business someday, preferably a call center. I also want a Montero Sport, a Mercedes-Benz. I want big savings and I want to travel around the world. And the most important thing of all, I want a happy family. So imagine when, ladies and gentlemen, if you make your dream board in your vision board, and you see this every day, imagine how that's going to motivate you in working for your goal and reaching your success. Number two, commitment. Commit to your goals. The people who waits for the right time to work on their goals will end up never getting their goals. Gumawa ka din naman ng goal, make sure you stick with your plan. You have to visualize yourself that you can get there. You have to see yourself you're already there. Or hindi, you know what? Starting now, you are successful. Successful ka na ngayon. You have it already. It's just waiting for you in the future. Number three, change your vocabulary. Like for example, instead of saying, I can't do this, say, I can do it. You know, words are very powerful. You know how our world and our universe was created? It says in Genesis, before there was light, what did God say? God said, let there be light. At nagkaroon ng ilaw. Hindi muna nagkaroon ng ilaw bago muna niya sinabi. Biglang nagkaroon ng ilaw, tapos sabi ni God, oh, let there be light. Diba? Of course, it doesn't go like that. God said, let there be light. Then there was light. Remember, we are made in His image and likeness. So we were given the power of words. Kaya your words are powerful. So use them with care. If you say something bad about yourself and you always talk negative, mangyayari sa buhay mo yan. Kaya say positive words. Be careful what you say because your words are very powerful. Number four, set a price for your dreams and start planning. Like for example, ito yung price ng dream ko. This is my whole lifetime dream and goal. Is 71.2 million pesos. Now let's say sa mga tao nang gusto lang kumita ng extra income sa multi-level marketing. You have to divide your big goals into small goals. For example, gusto mo kumita ng 150,000 pesos per year na extra income, then divide it into monthly goals, weekly goals, and daily goals. So you have to make 450 pesos per day so you can make an extra 150,000 pesos per year. Now your daily method of operation is the most important. What you do today is what makes a big difference. Yung weekly mo, yung monthly mo, yearly mo, I'm telling you that's nothing. Just work consistently. If you can have a consistent successful day, you will end up very successful. Sa retailing alone lang, pwede tayo magkaroon ng 150,000 pesos per year or an extra 12,500 pesos per month. This is just doing it part-time. Ay, paano pag gusto mo magkaroon ng 5,000 downlines? So, i-divide mo yan into small goals. So, paano yan? Yung buong year, goal mo magkaroon ng 5,000 member. Monthly target mo is 417, weekly is 104 members, at yung daily, kailangan may ma-sponsor ka na 15 na katao na daily. If you can get 15 members daily, then you will get your goal to have 5,000 members in 1 year. Remember, this is a group effort. Hindi mo lang gagawin ito mag-isa. Pero pag nagawa mo yan mag-isa, magaling ka, kaibigan. Now remember to set your goals, make a plan, get to work, stick to it, and reach your goal. Now the mistake in setting goals is masyadong malaki, masyadong marami, hindi specific, at hindi nila sinusulat, at hindi nila pinaplano. That's the greatest mistake in setting your goals. Number 5, have your to-do list. List the most 6 important things you need to do tomorrow. So every night before you go to bed, take 10 to 15 minutes before you go to bed to make sure you write down the 6 most important things you need to do the next following day. Unless you discipline yourself on a daily basis, the chances are you are not going to reach your goals. Number 6, monitor your success and failures. You must at least achieve 80 to 90% of your goals. Number 7, time management. If you're telling me you have no time, you are bullshitting me. That is bullshit. Why? Because everyone has 24 hours a day. You know why you're bullshitting me? Ito, papaliwanag ko sa iyo, ha? We have 24 hours a day times 7 days. That's a total of 168 hours per week. You spend 8 hours of sleeping, 9 hours of working, 30 minutes to get ready to go to work, 30 minutes to go to work, and 30 minutes to come back home from work. Now, if you add all that up, you only spend 18 hours and 30 minutes in the whole day. You still have 5 hours and 30 minutes per day. that gives you 38 hours per week. Yan ang free time mo. Tapos sasabihin mo sa akin, wala kang time? That's bullshit. Successful people uses their free time to be productive. Non-successful people uses their free time in miscellaneous things. Ito yung tanong, kaibigan. Anong ginagawa mo sa free time mo? There are no excuses. Everybody can do this business. Everybody has the free time. People have the time. Pero problema lang kasi is that people just have the lack of direction. Kaya please, people, don't tell me that you don't have no time. Kasi alam ko, hindi ako tanga. At alam ko, hindi ka din tanga. So wag na tayo maglokohan. Kung talagang seryoso ka sa negosyo nito, let's do it together and let's make a lot of money. Now number 8, learn to discipline yourself. Don't wait until you are motivated to do it. Yung tipong, ay hindi ako ginaganahan ngayon, bukas ko na lang gagawin pag ginanahan ako. Just do it. Action creates results. Therefore, results creates motivation. And when you are motivated, motivation creates energy. So remember, before you get motivation, you have to get the results. Before you get the results, you have to just do it. Number 9, learn how to manage your disappointments. Yung mga successful people at yung mga tao na hindi magiging successful, lahat yan, they go through disappointments. Learn to forgive yourself and get right back up when you fall and move on forward. Yung mga successful na tao, they learn how to get right back up pag nag-fail sila. It's not how hard you fall, but it's how fast you get back up. Okay, remember, learn how to control and manage your disappointments. Proverbs 24:16 says, "For through a righteous man falls 7 times, he rises again." Ito yung nakakatawa eh. Failures, when they fall, they don't get back up. What they do is they sleep on it. Dinadaan na lang sa tulog. Yung iba, dinadaan sa pagkain. And number 10, put your plan into action. Plano ka ng plano dyan. Ang ganda ng plano mo kung paano ka magiging successful sa network marketing business mo. So, biglang walang action. Be creative when you make your goals. Just remember, this is an art. So as the days goes by and when you keep on setting your goals, you'll get better and better and better in setting your goals and you'll see that you're achieving your goals even better and better and better. So never stop writing your goals down. Never stop planning. Goal setting is one of the most important things that you can learn in your life. Ako po ulit si Herbert Bacod and I want to say good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to you guys all. May you guys have a wonderful day. God bless and happy networking.